Real music, real interviews, real information. That's why we call it Real Gospel with the X-Man.
Turn your radios up because this is no doubt Real Gospel.
I don't want to be that lie to make a second guess who I'm representing. And no, I'm not perfect. No, I'm not ashamed to confess. I just want you to see that I'm trying. And no, it's not a game. Ain't gonna lose no sleep.
But I just think it needs to be said. Y'all don't really get the picture. Focus your attention on what really matters instead. Leave it or not, I'm with ya. Don't get too caught up in what you see on the ground. I will stay high for you, cause that's just who I am. You ain't laid down. You ain't laid down. You ain't laid down. You ain't laid down.
Soul Gospel is the place where God gets the glory and artists tell their stories. I'm honored to welcome back this family group to the program, the Walls Group. Welcome back to Real Gospel, everybody.
Hey, ma'am.
Hey.
Now, introduce yourself to the listeners because they may not know, they may not be familiar with whom you are. There's somebody who just found Jesus Christ yesterday, so they may not be familiar with you. So introduce yourselves to the listeners.
Well, I'm Daryl.
I'm Maria.
I'm Paco.
I'm Aja.
You're the Walls. You're the Walls Group. Y'all got to speak up. Sound excited. Come on now. Yeah. So I'm loving the song. I'm digging the song that you all just released, which is called My Life. So talk to us about, well, before we talk about My Life, like I started off the program, you've been on my program before, twice before, but since then, you all have been busy holding up the Bloodstained banner. People have given their hearts to the Lord, so they may not know who you are. Tell them a little bit about who you are and how you came to be the Walls Group.
Well, this is Aja. I guess, well, we're the Walls Group. We're a sibling group, four people. We sing for the Lord.
Just a little louder, my friend. Aja, just a little louder.
Well, this is Aja. We're the Walls Group. We're a sibling group, four people. We sing for the Lord because that's just kind of what we've always done. But not only just that, but we sing for God because it's always been a thing where, you know, he gave us our gift, so, you know, we've always just wanted to give it back. You know, whatever we could do, you know, for kingdom, and, you know, what we wanted to do what the Lord called us to do. And a long time ago, we kind of just discovered that this was what he ordained for us. So since maybe 2009, 2010, this is what we've been doing.
So are you all PKs? How did, I mean, because y'all related, correct? Brothers and sisters, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So were y'all raised in the church? You know, there's some large families listening right now. There's four, five, six, seven kids, you know, maybe three or four. And so maybe they're being, as my kids put it, they're being sort of forced to go to church. But so what do you say to them? So, yeah.
Well, we are not PKs. We say we're MKs. Our parents were musicians and ministers of music and stuff like that at church. So we weren't forced to go, but we were like, we had to go.
Strongly encouraged, right?
Yeah. Because the difference, though,
right,
at the fun side of church to us, because we had the musical side, you know, the musician and the singing, the choir, the drums, everybody, we had that side. So it was like we loved that aspect of it because it was in our household all the time. But yeah, we were in church all our lives, but for us, it wasn't really like the I hate to go to church type of thing. It was just like, you get to do the fun stuff, right? You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that's who we are.
We're
MKs instead of PKs.
Okay, that's what's up. So now, you all, let's talk about the new song, My Life. Did you all write and produce this? What's the history of this song?
This is Aja again. we did write and produce. Well, we did write. Warren Campbell produced it, and Damon Thomas produced it, and Eric Dawkins wrote with us on the song, and I think it kind of came about. Daryl coined this term, let me be great. Like, whenever somebody would try to check him, would be like, oh, you know, don't do that, or, you know, whatever, he'd be like, hey, like, let me be great. And Warren heard this and was just like, you know, he made me great, so let me be great, you know? And the whole concept kind of came about because in our lives, what we've experienced being in the industry, being young Christians, and in the public eye, people are always trying to tell us what we shouldn't wear, should wear, should look like. Right. Like, you know, they always want us to conform to some type of, their type of rule of what they feel like we should be like or act like. And the song just kind of says, I know who I am in Christ, and I know what God called me to do, so let me do that. You know, let me live my life, and I'm going to let you live yours.
That's interesting. So you are encountering people who want to have you conform or place you inside of a box. Is that sort of what I'm hearing?
Pretty much, yeah.
So what do you say? How do you speak back to that? You know, they're youth right now. And that's a complaint. Probably, I know that's a complaint in my church. I've heard that complaint in many churches throughout the nation. So speak to that right now. There's some pastors listening. There's some youth pastors listening. Speak to that, putting, you know, dealing with youth and how people in your generation and below are how you all experience God. Speak to that crowd right now.
Okay, this is Paco. I would say that we experience God in a very real and unique way, and it's not a way that can be that. It's not a way that can be, you know, like doused or, you know, put down by standards or a set of rules or a way to look or a way to be. You know, God calls us to be. God calls us to be, you know, unique. God calls us to our own box and our own specific thing. And it's not something that you can put your own brand or stamp on. And, you know, and I think that's kind of why you see a lot of millennials or younger people at these, you know, these dip out of the box type churches, because they're able to be themselves there and they're able to experience and worship God in the way that He would have them to, or they're able to be who they are in God in the way that He would have them to, and there's no limits or barriers on that. And I think that's really the thing right now with young people. They just want to be them, and for so long they weren't able to be.
Wow. So let me ask you, do you think that the youth today are looking for something that's real, whereas tradition has its place, but it's probably had it's had its shelf life, that we're in a season where, you know, as the scriptures say, you know, God is pouring out His Spirit among all flesh. And so young folk in this day and age, maybe, oh, y'all looking for something that's more real, the move of God, the wonders, the signs, the miracles, those type of things. Are we in that day now?
Oh, absolutely.
We all agree. The thing about it is we've been having this conversation a lot lately. Even in the traditional way of church, how we grew up, we saw a lot of things in tradition that we're lacking in right now. Like, so in tradition, we've seen, you know, people, we've seen people get up from the dead. They died in church and get back up. Or we've seen people get up from who haven't walked in years, but they got up and they start walking. We've seen those things, but we don't see them a lot now because of, we understand that there are different things that God is calling us to do, and there's so much more that He wants from His people, not just His this generation, but the last generation, that everybody is just kind of like doing the same thing. But when you read in the Word, you see that He doesn't do the same thing all the time. He's always doing something different. So if He's always doing something different, then that means a lot of the stuff that we used to do ain't working no more. You know what I'm saying? That's what the church needs a little bit of a revamp and try to kind of critique what God is really wanting and what He's saying for us to do. And I thought it's funny because He's calling a lot of young people, because a lot of young people are seeking truth and they're seeking, you know, the real and the authentic. So He's like, oh, well, you're ready to listen, so let me talk to you for a while. Hey, I need you to go and go do this. So when somebody young does something different like us, it's kind of like, what are y'all doing? And we're like, well, God told us to do it, so we're doing it. You know what I'm saying? And you have to be strong in faith, because if you don't, people can really make you feel like you're not doing what God is supposed, like the right thing, because it's not what they think it is. But you have to be strong in your faith, and you have to know that God has called you to something different. It's like in David. David didn't use the traditional armor to fight and kill Goliath. He used what God taught him, and how it was a slingshot and a rock to kill Goliath. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of what it is.
Amen. Amen. See, that's what you get when you go to a Walls Group concert. You get the music and you get the spoken word. See, somebody's going to break out and start preaching at one of your concerts. Watch and see. Come on now. I hear it.
Already have.
See, I need to get to one of y'all's concerts. So speaking of concerts, speaking of traveling, speaking of music, this latest song, I'm digging it. I'm feeling it. I'm loving it. What can we expect from the project?
It's awesome. From this project, I'm going to tell you when you can expect it first, so, you know, get excited. but I think what most people can expect from this body of work first is kind of just our perspective on, you know, who God has been to us, you know, what he's taken us through in our journey recently in our walk with God. I think people can kind of just expect the unexpected. I will say that. You don't know what you're going to get on this record, you know, in terms of music. We got country, we got
country,
quartet, we got okay. 90s R&B.
What y'all know about country?
Everything on here.
What y'all know about country? Okay. All right. We shall see. We shall see. So any surprise artists, guests on this project?
Oh, but definitely. We got, of course, we had Warren Campbell who worked on it with us. We got Eric Dawson.
Yeah.
We have PJ Morton who played on the record. We also got Tim Rogers on this thing, singing heaven down in here, man. So, yeah.
Man, y'all have Warren Campbell, PJ Morton, and you've got some heavy hitters. What was it like working with Warren Campbell, though?
This is Paco. Working with Warren was weird. It wasn't like anything that we thought it would be like. It was actually very unexpected. Like the first day we came in, you know, we're so used to getting to work and, you know, here, do this, you know, go in the booth and try this. Hey, go sing this. And the first day we ended up like for like 7 hours, like sitting around acting a fool and talking and laughing, and we left like, yo, what the heck? We just wasted so much time. And the next day, we asked him about it. We was like, yo, hey, so you think today was gonna work? He's like, yo, we didn't work yesterday. I was waiting on y'all. And I was like, what? Like, that was so weird. But it was very hands. He was very hands off, and he was very, you know, you can do what you do, you know. What do you want? Like, what are you doing? You know, what you got? And, you know, I can work with you because at the end of the day, this is y'all's project. And I'm just trying to get to know y'all first. And second, I'm not trying to give you what I want y'all to do. I want us to create around y'all's ideas and y'all's visions and y'all's ministry. And to me, I think to all of us, that was the dopest part. You know, it's just, he's a really great dude. And you don't meet too many great people out here.
Amen. That's what's up. I enjoyed that. So is there a Walls Group reality show in the works? she laughed. Don't want to show the personal moments of your lives just yet, huh?
we will see.
I guess that's where your shout, God is still working on us.
Well, you know, God is still working on the show, too.
Yeah, see? That's what's up. It's been a pleasure and an honor having you all on the program. Where can the listeners find out more about you? Where can they get your music? Where can they reach you?
Well, you guys can find our music anywhere from Spotify, to Amazon, Google Play, iTunes. Pretty much if it's a music network, search our name, Tidal. Now, you can find us on Tidal. You can see us in concert or find out when we're coming to your city on our website at www.thewallsgroup.org. We just got a makeover on our website, so head over there and, you know, see when we're coming to your city. Don't miss it. You don't want to miss it. You can also follow all of our social media. Everything is at The Walls Group. Instagram, Twitter, MySpace, Facebook, you name it, we got it.
Amen. But one last question. Are y'all finding a lot of youth at your concerts? Are they showing up?
Always.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
More youth than anyone else.
Excellent. So ministers of music that are listening, pastors that are listening, youth pastors that are listening, make sure you have the Walls Group at your ministry. Set the whole bill around impacting the youth, impacting people, but in primarily your youth. They will definitely enjoy the Walls Group. They have a message. They've got great music, and this is what it's all about, supporting the next generation, and you all have nothing but our support from all of us here on Real Gospel. Okay, my friends?
We appreciate that so much, man.
You are welcome. You all have a blessed rest of the day, and I look forward to talking to you again real soon.
Yes, sir.
All right, you too. Thank you.
If you reach out to me right now, you can check out this interview on my Facebook page, Real Gospel with the X-Man, on my Twitter, Real Gospel X-Man. By the way, it's almost time for the Real Flashback Song of the Hour, which is coming up right after this break. So go to my social media sites, Real Gospel with the X-Man on Facebook and Real Gospel with the X-Man on Twitter. I want to hear from you. You are the listeners. I do this for you, all right? So the Real Flashback Song of the Hour is not just about me. It's also about you and what you would like to hear. It's up next, right after this.
You're listening to Real Gospel with the X-Man.